A Mom After God's Own Heart by Elizabeth George. This audio version is published by Oasis Audio through an agreement with Harvest House Publishers. A Mom After God's Own Heart is read by Elizabeth George.
A word of welcome. Dear Mom, without even meeting you, I can tell you are someone very special. Why? Because you're choosing to listen to this audiobook. When you consider its title, it becomes pretty obvious that you desire to be a mom after God's own heart. This audiobook is packed with information and how-tos that will show you how to fulfill the desires of your mother heart, how to become a mom after God's own heart. As we begin our journey together, a few things will make it even sweeter. Open your book and enjoy it. Vital information is here. Encouragement is here. God's Word is here. I've even tried to make it easy to take in for you as a busy woman and mom. In my mind, I've pictured you listening to this audiobook in a quiet moment after the kids leave for school, or while the little ones are napping, or as you wait up for your teen to come home, or as you rock your baby to sleep, or maybe even as you recline against a tree while your kids enjoy a romp in the park. Enjoy your audiobook. Carry it with you. And let God's Word instruct you and give you a power boost and a pat on the back all at the same time. Open your heart to the priorities and topics covered in this audiobook. They are tailor-made just for you, Mom. They'll give you God's wisdom and guidelines for this major role in your life. Open your heart through prayer to the Holy Spirit. Ask Him to illuminate God's Word, to help you understand God's plan and priorities for your life, and to transform you, heart and soul. Open your heart to others. Look around. Are there other moms in your church or neighborhood who would benefit from learning what being a mom is all about? Invite them to get a mom after God's own heart, too, and go through it together. Then you'll be growing as moms and in the things of the Lord. And to really accelerate your understanding, go through the A Mom After God's Own Heart Growth and Study Guide. You'll love it. Open your heart and dream. Dream of becoming the mom you yearn to be, a mom after God's own heart. And now let's put feet on those dreams. It is the prayer of my heart that the contents of this special audiobook for moms like you will encourage you, excite you, instruct you, and inspire you to follow after God's own heart. In His great and amazing love, your friend and fellow mom in Christ. Focusing on the heart. Keep your heart with all diligence, for out of it spring the issues of life. Proverbs 4, verse 23. No matter what you do each day or in life, doing things God's way is a matter of the heart. Whether it's deciding how to spend your money or your time, how you treat people, how you dress, or how you do your work, your choices reveal your heart. And the same is true when it comes to how you raise your children, no matter what their ages. Why is the condition of the heart, both yours as a mom and the heart of your child, so critical? The Bible answers this all-important question. At the heart of all things. As you already know from personal experience, the heart is the chief organ of physical life. It's obvious to everyone that the heart occupies the most important place in the human system. But the heart, as used in the Bible, also stands for our entire mental and moral activity, including the emotions, the ability to reason, and the will. The heart is also used figuratively for the hidden springs of the personal life. That's why God warns and instructs us to keep our heart with all diligence, for out of it spring the issues of life. In other words, we are to present our entire beings to God, and the heart is first. It speaks of the inner life, the mind, the thoughts, the motives, the desires. The mind is the fountain from which the actions flow. If the fountain is pure, the stream that flows from it will be pure. As a man thinks, so is he. God begins molding a mother after his own heart on the inside, in the inner woman and her heart, and then works outward. So what does this have to do with being a mom? First, we need to know how important our child's heart is. W.E. Vine, giving insights into Matthew 15, verses 19 and 20, wrote, "Human depravity is in the heart, because sin is a principle which has its seat in the center of man's inward life and then defiles the whole circuit of his action." That's the bad news. But second, and here comes the good news, Scripture regards the heart as the sphere of divine influence. Romans 2, verse 15, Acts 15, verse 9. So here, my fellow mom, is our twofold challenge. To raise and keep on raising a child after God's own heart, we must till the soil of each tender heart and sow the seed of the Word of God while praying fervently for divine influence. At the same time, we must devote ourselves to diligently training and to dealing with and disciplining the sin that is a part of every child's life. But where does all of this mothering, committing, praying, dedicating, dealing with, and disciplining begin? It starts in your heart, dear mom. As moms, our job assignment from God is to raise children after God's own heart. Children who seek to follow God and hopefully experience salvation through Jesus Christ. And following through on God's plan for us is all about our hearts. It's all about fulfilling God's instructions to us. He wants us to focus on giving our heart, soul, mind, strength, and time to influencing and shaping the hearts of our children toward God and His purposes. Children with a heart for God. You can probably think of men and women in the Bible who had hearts for God, who followed after Him. But there are also a number of children in the Bible who had hearts for God, ranging all the way from preschoolers to preteens to young adults. These children loved and served God in a variety of ways. And each one of their stories has lessons for us as moms after God's own heart, no matter what our children's ages. Samuel. Everyone from toddlers to grandparents alike loves the story of the boy Samuel's response to God's call. You can read about this part of Samuel's life in 1 Samuel 3, verses 1 through 21. It's what we dream of for our own growing children, that they never know what it's like to not love and follow God. That's how I see Samuel. He's the young guy whom most believe, at around 12 or 13 years old, heard God calling him and answered. What made Samuel a child after God's own heart? In 1 Samuel 3, we read that he heard God's call and answered him. He listened to what God had to say, and he responded to the voice of the Lord, saying, "Here I am. Speak, for your servant hears." From the heart actions of the boy Samuel, it's apparent that children, even at a very young age, are able to make significant spiritual commitments and substantial contributions to the work of God. Where does such a heart come from? Certainly, first and foremost, it comes from God Himself. He is the maker and creator of all good things, including a heart that hears, listens, answers, and responds to Him. But on the heels of this right response, we might also add, and from Samuel's mother. Who was she? Her name was Hannah, and she was the woman who prayed to God and vowed, O Lord of hosts, if you will give me, your maidservant, a male child, then I will give him to the Lord all the days of his life. 1 Samuel 1, verse 11. The answer to this prayer from Hannah's heart was Samuel, who was dedicated to the Lord before he was even conceived. And to fulfill her vow, Hannah took Samuel to the house of the Lord in Shiloh when he was weaned at about age 3. And there she handed her little tyke over to Eli, God's priest, to be raised under his direct superintendence and instruction in the shadow of the house of the Lord. A mother's greatest joy in having a child is to give that child fully and freely to God. By age 3, it appears little Samuel was well on his way to becoming a child after God's own heart. From that tender age, he ministered to the Lord before Eli the priest. 1 Samuel 2, verse 11. And where did such a heart begin to take shape? Again, it all began in the plan of God. But another factor in God's plan was the faithfulness of a mother after God's own heart. Imagine a mom who could pray the prayer Hannah prayed in 1 Samuel 2, verses 1 through 10. Be sure to read it for yourself. Imagine her fervent love for God, her knowledge of God through the Pentateuch, the first 5 books in the Bible, and from his dealings with his people throughout history. Imagine her intense instruction to her little one and her passionate prayers on his behalf as she prepared to deposit her preschooler in Shiloh. I pray that such a burning dedication to God and to teaching and training our children is true of you and me too. David. David was the original man after God's own heart. 1 Samuel 13, verse 14. But he was also a boy after God's own heart. Scholars believe David was between 10 and 16 years old when Samuel, who grew up to be a prophet and priest, anointed David to be king over Judah. David was brought up to be a shepherd, and there on the slopes of Judah's rolling hills, David, already a lover of the Lord, tended his father's sheep, wrote prayers to God, and sang them to the Lord while playing on his stringed instrument. When concluding a study of David's life, one scholar wrote in a homily entitled, God's Love for Little Boys. It is impossible to overestimate the great things which become possible when a young life is surrendered to Almighty God. And where does such a soft heart for God in a little boy come from? Of course, it began in the sovereign plan of God, but look also at David's spiritual family tree. Salmon, who married Rahab.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.